This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to find the target profit in units or sales dollars for organizations that pay income taxes. And there are three steps in this process. The first step is to figure out, first of all, what we want our target profit to be after taxes. And after taxes is the key piece of this. That is, we want to know how much our desired target profit is after we pay income taxes. The second step is to convert the desired target profit after taxes to the target profit before taxes. That is, it's going to be a higher number, the before tax number, because we're going to have to pay some taxes. So we want to know what our desired target profit is before taxes. And the way to do that is, that's this calculation right here. The way to figure out the target profit before taxes is to take the target profit after taxes and divide by 1 minus the tax rate. And on the next slide, we'll take a look at how best to do that. Step 3, then, is to use the target profit before taxes, that is the calculation in step 2, to calculate the target profit in units or in sales dollars. Here's an example. A snowboard company produces one type of snowboard, and the sales price per unit, all the information is here, the sales price per unit is $250, and you'll see that right here. The variable cost per unit is $150. Remember, the sales price per unit minus the variable cost per unit is the unit contribution margin, so I'll put that here as well, is $100. The fixed costs per month total $50,000, and our target profit after taxes, remember that's step one, is to figure out, well, what is it we want to make after taxes and profit, is $30,000, and the tax rate is 20%. So let's take a look at how to use all this information to figure out the target profit in units and sales dollars after taxes. As I mentioned in the previous slides, step one is determining the desired profit after taxes. And we've already determined that we want to know what it will take in number of unit sales or sales dollars to make $30,000 in after-tax profit. So step two is to convert that $30,000 in after-tax profit to profit before taxes. And as we mentioned before, the way to do that is to take our after-tax profit, $30,000 in this example, here it is, and divide that by 1 minus the tax rate. And remember, I gave you a tax rate of 20% on the previous slide, so we're going to divide that by 1 minus 20%, or 1 minus 0.2. And what that tells us is we want $37,500 in profit before taxes, meaning our taxes are going to be 20% of that, or $7,500, and so that $7,500 would be deducted from this $37,500 to get $30,000 in profit after tax. Now that we have our target profit before taxes, we figured that out back in step two on the previous slide, we can figure out the target profit in units or in sales dollars. And so for this calculation, we're going to use units. So to find the break-even point, this is the formula that you see here. We're going to take the total fixed costs that was provided a couple of slides back. We're going to add to that the target profit before taxes, which we have determined to be $37,500 on the previous slide. And then we're going to divide that by the contribution margin per unit. I had mistakenly put in here weighted average contribution margin per unit, but there's really no need to take a weighted average since we only have one product. So it's just simply divided by the contribution margin per unit. And in this example, the contribution margin per unit is right here, the denominator of the equation, $250 sales price minus the $150 variable cost. And those are both per unit pieces of information. Therefore, the unit contribution margin is $100. The end result, when we take $50,000 plus $37,500 and divide it by the $250 minus $150, the end result is that we have to sell 875 units to make $30,000 after taxes.